social media at Leanne K. Bowes, LeanneKBowes.
And we're here at the Artist Relations Expo event at Hybrid Studios. And just wanted to chat with you a little bit about what gear you play. So you're playing bass. What bass do you play?
My favorite bass is a Fender P-Bass. I've been playing Fender since I was a kid, since I picked it up for the first time. So I've always had P-Basses. I also have a Fender Jazz Bass. But the bass I was playing tonight is a 2008 Fender P-Bass in Blizzard Pearl, which was a 2008 edition color. It's my favorite bass. You will usually see me in pictures playing that bass.
Now, when you look for a bass, what do you look for in terms of tone?
In terms of tone, I do a lot of pop punk and rock music, so I don't do a lot of jazz. I do some singer-songwriter sort of music, but not a lot of that pop tone, that sort of smoother tone, is not what I play. So typically a more punchy tone, just the dual pickups. I actually play with both the pick and my fingers, so as long as the bass can sort of handle the pick without being too high, the tone being too high, that's typically what I look for.
Now, when did you start playing?
I started playing when I was a kid. I was 12 years old. My dad was actually a drummer, and he had a bass lying around, and he actually wanted to record MIDI for the first time. He set up a new computer, and he was like, I want to try a dual input, so he handed me a bass. He was like, just try this. And we played The Police. We played So Lonely by The Police, and he played the drums, and I played bass, and we just recorded it, and then I just learned every CD in my parents' house from there. I just kept going with bass.
Did you teach yourself, or did you?
I did, yeah.
Wow. Who were some of your inspirations growing up?
A lot of Green Day, no doubt, that kind of stuff, the 90s, the grungy stuff, System of a Down. I learned, my parents luckily had very young taste in music at the time, so I was learning all the Nirvana albums, some Rush, some things like that, but mostly that 90s grunge was my inspiration.
Speaking of Rush.
Yeah, I was actually just talking about, I used to watch it's a VHS set of Neil Peart. It was this overhead drum cam, and I just remember I used to just watch that, as if it was a movie. I was a kid just watching that all the time, and it's pretty intense to think about that, and it's every drummer I play with, we've all just been talking about it and reminiscing about the first time we heard it, first time we tried to play a Rush song and failed.
So you're from LA. Just wondered, what's one of your favorite spots in LA?
So I actually only moved to LA 2 years ago, so I'm I consider myself new. I'm from the East Coast originally, but my favorite spots in LA, I love Lucky Strike, that venue. I love playing there. Yeah. We just actually had a gig there a couple nights ago. It was my second time there, and just great sound, just great venue. I love the vibe there. That's definitely one of my favorite venues to play. I live in Echo Park, so I'm used to that sort of neighborhood. I like Echo Park a lot.
Okay, so advice for someone wanting to move to LA and get in the music industry?
Yeah, it's all about networking. I would say when you first arrive in LA, it's a lot about just getting out there. I mean, that's it. It's just going to the jams. There's so much in LA for you as a musician. There's so much kind of handed to you in a lot of ways that you don't see in other cities. So just getting yourself out there. As tired as you are,